Alright guys, I know you all are kind of stressed at home and I figured that you guys have some gadgets lying around which you really want to learn about. I think this is a very good time to, you know, learn about things and utilize this moment. So what I figured for today's video topic is going to be the GoPro, the thing that you have in your cupboard which you are really reluctant to use because you think the footage from it is crappy. But I assure you, the footage from this is not at all crappy. You have a lot of settings to play around with, a lot of things, and I'm going to teach you the settings in this part of part 1 or part 2 video series where I'm going to be talking about my GoPro, which is a Hero 5. No matter what Hero 5 or Hero 7 or Hero 6 or Hero 4 you have, whatever it is, you have a GoPro, that's all that matters. And I'm gonna make sure that you get the best out of it through this video. So welcome to part 1 of how to use your GoPro and make amazing cinematic footage. Let's get started. Yeah, okay. So now we are back at the screen where everything is set to, reset to default. For cinematic stuff, what I prefer is going to resolution. We'll start with the simple stuff, that is a resolution deal, okay? So what you're gonna do is go to resolution, go to 2.7. You can go for 144. I haven't, you know, seen much problem with it. People do like this ratio because it helps you like crop out it later on. But I personally prefer sticking to 16:9 ratio, and that is 2.7K. And you don't want to use 4K, to be very honest, because I find 60 FPS a very big deal breaker when it comes to action videos, and people feel like it's really smooth. The video you are watching right now is shot in 60 frames per second, and you really like it. I hope you do. Anyway, you have these resolutions to choose from. It really depends on what capacity of editing your computer can handle. It's really up to how you perceive yourself as an editor. So these things are not to be messed around with if you're not knowing what to do. So you can just choose 2.7K or 180p if you're really going for cinematic stuff, alright? Alongside that, there is a FPS count over here, and I would recommend 60, but for cinematic stuff, a lot of people choose 30. You can downscale it down, and you know, when you're editing it later on in post-production, that is, I'm gonna do it in part 2. I usually 60 frames per second, and then I reduce it down to 30 or 24 if I need to, because most films are shot in 24 frames per second. That's one of the reasons why cinematic stuff feel a bit slow. Anyway, FOV is a very situational, I could say, because if you put 60 frames per second, you won't get super wide over here, and super wide is only good for people who are going for biking. So like, let's say you, if I recall properly, sorry, 180p will give you super wide. So if you're going for like cinematic stuff, I would recommend medium, and we'll go back to 2.7 and 60. So this is pretty much a good setting. If you really want to go push the limit, you can go for linear too. That's completely flat as in like just straight like a normal camera. So you can go for that if you really, you know, want to push yourself. I'm sorry if I'm covering up with my fingers. I'm leaving everything down in the description so that you guys have a better idea what I'm doing, okay? So do check it out again. So we are done with the screen. Now we can go, we are on the video mode, by the way. So we can go swipe to the right, and we are going to enable ProTune, okay? This is a very important setting because this gives you manual control over your video. So you're going to enable ProTune, and you're going to go for the color options and everything over here. You're going to give a good look over here. So I'll go one by one and then explain each one and then move to the next one, alright? So color, you would go for flat. You know, you won't notice it with your eye when it changes instantaneously, but all the greens and all the, you know, saturation is reduced. This is good because if you're going to do something later on in post-production, which we are, I would suggest you guys to go with color profile that's flat. White balance auto would be a problem because there are times when I've gone for a ride, and then the day I would go early in the morning, it'd be blue in color, and then by the evening it'd be yellow. So when I'm editing, I will have a headache because I'm gonna have to go through and change each clip's white balance to match it all over, you know, all over it maintains the same white balance. So it's gonna be a headache. So what I suggest is putting this around 55k, which I found very comfortable, very good range to be in. It hasn't messed up a lot. It gives you a lot of depth in your footage too. So I would go for 55k. ISO is basically how bright your scene is gonna be. This is artificially brightened. It's not because of the shutter speed or anything like that. So this is gonna bring in artificial stuff on the screen like grains. So you want to always stick to the lowest one. I do not want you to ever go beyond 800 in this setting. If you are in a case where in the evening and you really want to get some more detail in it, go for 800, but not beyond that. I would recommend you to boost it up later in post-production, but not in the camera, because this guy is a very little guy. How the footage is supposed to be like and what you're gonna do with the footage. So he's just doing his best job to get the best thing what you're pointing at. He doesn't do much other than that. messing around with shutter will result in a lot of things. Maybe at times you'll be walking and taking videos and that'd be fine. If you are traveling on a vehicle, that shutter is gonna mess up a lot of stuff. Then EV compensation is exposure compensation. I would generally leave it on minus 0.5 because I want a bit more comfortability. I don't want things to get overexposed. I don't want the details to be lost in the bright sides. So I keep it at 0.5. Sharpness, this is a very bad setting. I don't know why it even exists. Just leave it at low because it kind of messes up with the edges and sharp edges and glowing stuff and all. Audio, I would leave it at high. I haven't much seen a big difference in that. So anyway, that's that. You can leave this on if you really wanna, you know, this kind of stabilizes your footage but crops out 10% of it from the edges. So if you are like shooting something, perhaps that cup over there, I would want you to take extra 10% of footage around it so that, you know, when you step, this guy stabilizes it, you know it's gonna get cropped and you don't wanna lose that. So basically, yeah, just you keeping this on. Then auto low light, I wouldn't recommend this because it kind of messes with the shutter speed and it makes the video very choppy. I do not recommend this at all. Just keep it off, alright? Then manual audio control, I don't think this guy's mic is really powerful unless and until you have a worst case scenario where you really badly need to record yourself using the GoPro, then go for this and turn it on. Then if that's the case, you can keep it in stereo only because it records very well in stereo, and wind only is kind of fucked up because when you go traveling, I have experimented with this, you cannot hear a pitch of sound. I mean, it's very personal, to be honest. I don't know, each GoPro has its own perks, I guess, and the 7 and the 8 have better mics, I've heard. So whether you're shooting cinematic stuff, so it really depends on that. So other than that, we are pretty much good with the settings for our cinematic shots to be taken on the GoPro. So now what I would recommend is to go out and grab some footage, and I want you guys to be very careful that you shoot with the sky and you want to keep rule of thirds, and I want you guys to be stable with you. If you have a tripod or a mini selfie stick, keep it on that, and then keep this GoPro stable when you're taking shots. So let's go on to the editing. If you're done with part one, obviously you can jump on to part two. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know there's not much you enjoy. I hope really it was informative, and I hope you're following the guidelines I've given in my previous video regarding how to avoid the COVID-19 and to stay at home. Since India has declared a lockdown for 21 days, we are pretty much stuck with either Netflix, or some people are stuck with their girlfriends, some people are stuck with a lot of other stuff. So, in other words, what I'm trying to imply is make the best out of this time and be positive. It's gonna be all okay. Leave a like if you like the video, and make sure you subscribe if you like my content. Otherwise, if you have some advice or did I fuck up somewhere in the video, please leave it down in the comments. I will make sure that I fix it in my next video. Thank you, and sorry about the audio in previous video. I made sure the audio will be better in this one. So let's look for that ahead in future. Peace.